Welcome to another software tutorial, and in this one we're going to be doing two methods of doing transparency patches, or giving patches transparency in your video compositing. In Blender here we have 2.69, but 2.71 or 2 will do fine. It's basically the same theory. First we go to the movie clip editor and import your video. In this one I want to put a bit of texture onto this rock here. I can basically go to this button here and go dope sheet and bring that down, go to mask, and in this mask here select mask, and that will give me the situation where if I click this button here I now have keyframes activated and I can start rotoscoping my mask so that I'm going to generate different keyframes, for example here, and start rotoscoping around the cloak of the character here. Right, so it's basically going to move around. So I'll just do a couple here for you just to give you the idea, and there it is, animated, right? You can spend a lot of time on that. Next we're going to then go to the node editor, and we're going to click this button to activate the window. Use nodes will give us our nodes, and backdrop will give us a view of our backdrop. And if I connect that in the movie clip editor, I have already a movie node and the video selected and a viewer imported, so I can see on my backdrop here. Over here I have brought this window down here and selected the UV image editor render, and it will give me the composite. Nothing is connected at the moment, so it will now give me a final output of what I'm going to be looking at. I have also an image here of some rocks that I want to place on that patch there, and that is the rock here. I've got a transform node which I have imported, and that will, and I've rotated it and placed it more or less where I want it to go. I have the mask which is up here, and that gives me the black and white version of that mask. Black is transparent, white being opaque. Now if I mix them together by having a color mix node and put that into the line, activating my alpha button here and connecting the mixer to the viewer, yes, we're getting nothing at the moment. If I connect my movie to the bottom layer there, which is actually the top, I have my picture here. If I connect then the patch into the top one there, it will mix the two together and all of the transparency here will then disappear the rest of the background. So if I do it the other way around, swap those two, I will now have the movie clip image on the bottom layer, and putting the image on top with the transparency which will let the movie clip show through. So I now have my patch in the place that I want it, more or less, and now I can give it some transparency by using the factor button here. At the moment it's 1, which means it's full opacity. If I go down to 0, it will go to 0 opacity, and if I go to 0.5 it'll give me half, and you can choose what transparency you want. Now if I want to then cut out the patch around here by using that mask, I can put it into the factor button of the mix, and lo and behold I have it cut out, but I immediately lose the transparency information. So what I can do is the first method here, and we'll transfer that there, and we have that patch now coming in here. We can use this whole setup as the background patch, but without the mask, should I say, and this is going to be basically our patch material. If I take another mixer by adding a color mix, add color mix, put that into the line, and feed it off to the there. I'm going to feed the movie clip into the bottom, and then also activating the alpha so it gives me transparency. And now I've got the patch here on top of the original video. And now if I use the mask, I can now cut out that patch, and that leaves me this mix node to be able to adjust the transparency. Now I can animate that transparency by moving to somewhere on the timeline. For example, I want to fade that in, for example. I can then put that to zero by clicking on it, zero, enter, and that will give me a factor of zero, so it's totally disappeared. And I can move my cursor over top of the factor button and push the I key, and it will turn yellow, and here it will, you see, generate an orange line which says it's a keyframe. And if I go up to my dope sheet line that I have open up there, I can go to dope sheet, it'll give me a summary, and in the scene I have here, I have the also a registry of that, those keyframes that are there, which you can then, for example here, you can now move, delete, and add, delete those there. Go to another place in the timeline, and I'm going to then click on that, select, for example, points, and write in 0.7, and then move my cursor over top of that and push the I key again, and that, as you can see, has generated a keyframe, and you can see it down here on the timeline. Two orange lines are the two keyframes, which you can navigate between them by this button here, and go back to the first one, for example. Now that is one way, and you can see halfway between it will start to fade in and fade out and all that, controlling the transparency through using two mixer nodes, one to get the mix and the other to mix that patch and mask it with this one here. That's one way of doing it. Another way of doing it is to dispense with this mixer one here and go back to having a mixer and the mask and everything as we were before. Now remember that this mix, that this mask here was giving us a representation of the alpha channel. If I add a converter and go to set alpha, it will give me this node here where I can now use that black and white image to get the alpha, plug it into the alpha plug, and you will see that it will now give us this black patch. Everything else has gone transparent, and in this little image here is the image, which at the moment is a black thing. So if I now take the image that I had here and transformed and put it into the image plug, it will now give me the patch. Now I can use that situation to put it as a patch and put the original footage underneath, and now I have this patch here, and it leaves me this node here and this factor button to then animate the transparency. So now we not only have transparency, we have the rotoscoping, and that will fade in also. The mask will rotoscope or animate, and the transparency will also animate. And those two ways, using two mixers or a set alpha node into the one mixer, are two ways you can control your transparency of a patch.